Hi, welcome to Barney Tech channel. Here we are going to see about definite time and instantaneous overcurrent. For that I am going to take this simple switchgear and considering the fault detect on incomer. The all feeder load current is 40 amps and the full load current for incomer is 320 amps. For incomer alone we can consider three fault level. First overload fault, second fault at load end, third fault at nearer to the incomer. My previous video we discussed about overload fault. If you want to see, I have given link over description. Now we go directly to the fault at load end. For this fault, first we are going to check with IDMT. The curve which I selected was normal inverse. The ISET is 0.68. TMS is 0.8. Now we consider suddenly heavy fault occur on one of the feeder transformer. Due to this fault, the fault current taken is 2000 amp. This is the formula for normal inverse. Actual current in secondary due to this fault current and load current is 4.68 amp. It is greater than ISET, so the relay will start to pick up. If we substitute all value to the formula, we get trip time is 2.8 second. Now the incomer gives chance to the fault feeder to trip first. But if it is not tripping, then trip time is 2.8 second. The relay will give trip command to the breaker. This is the heavy fault for the outgoing feeder. For that, waiting for approximately 3 seconds is very dangerous for outgoing feeder as well as the incoming transformer. So using this IDMT for this fault at load end is not preferable. So I am going to check now with instantaneous overcurrent over here. For this I am going to keep ISET equal to 3.4 amps and trip time is 0 second. Now we consider suddenly heavy fault occur on one of the outgoing feeder transformer. Due to this fault, the fault current taken is 2000 amps. Actual current is 4.68 amps flows on secondary side of the CT. The actual current is greater than ISET. So the relay will start to get pickup and trip instantaneously. The most probably the feeder will also have trip instantaneously because it is heavy fault for the feeder. Or it may not trip, but incomer trip instantaneously without giving chance to the feeder, or both will get trip simultaneously. So this instantaneous settings also is not preferable. When we see IDMT and instantaneous, both are not satisfied. So third, I am going to select definite time that we check. For this I am going to keep ISET equal to 3.4 amps and trip time is 0.5 second. Now same fault occurs. Due to this fault, the fault current taken is 2000 amps. Actual current in secondary is 4.6 amp, which is greater than ISET. And the relay will get pickup and start to count for 0.5 seconds. Within this time, if the outgoing feeder get trips, then the incomer current will get reduced and it will be in service, so remaining all other load will get power supply. On other case, if the outgoing is failed to trip, then the incomer will take the chance and it will trip the breaker. The fault isolate time is also 0.5 seconds, only it is lesser time for isolating fault at load end. So for this type of fault we can choose definite time. Now we go for fault at nearer to incomer. Now I am going to check with definite overcurrent relay over here. For this I am going to take ISET equal to 6.8 amps and trip time is 0.5 second. Now we consider a sudden fault occurs nearer to the incomer. Due to this fault, the fault current is 5000 amps. Actual current flows on the secondaries of the CT is 10.6 amps along with load current, which is greater than ISET. Due to this, the relay will get pickup and wait for tripping for 0.5 second. For this fault, No other nearer breaker is there to isolate the fault. Only the incomer has to trip. So the time delay here is not much necessary. For better protection, I am going to check with instantaneous overcurrent. For this, I am going to keep ISET equal to 6.8 amps and trip time is 20 milliseconds, which is approximately to 0 second. Now we consider the suddenly heavy fault occur near to incomer. Due to this fault, same fault current we consider 5000 amps and the secondary current is also 10.64 amps, which is greater than ISET, and the relay will get pickup and trip instantaneously and the fault get isolated. Here the instantaneous overcurrent relay is much suitable over this place. This is the characteristics of definite time overcurrent relay. We see deeply over here, once the actual current touches the ISET value, the relay will wait that time until we set, then only it will trip. If you see in instantaneous characteristics, this is the characteristics curve for instantaneous. Once the ISET value reaches the I actual value, then it will start to give trip command within millisecond. On next video, I am going to make how to mix the curve, which will be improve the protection of the feeder. By this, we came to the end of the section. Be safe. See you on next video. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel. Thank you for watching this video.